Yes, I, blessed love, the viewers of Yetu African TV, you're welcome once again. It's me, Kaya Sana Mwakalobo. I say you're welcome, karibu sana. It's another episode, another week. Yeah, man. A lot of people have been, you know, African all over the world, you know, politically. They have been celebrating African Liberation Day. Yeah, man. So this day, it has a lot of reaction, you know, among Africans. So for some of us, you will hear a lot from now, but for some of us, we have a lot of critical points about the African Liberation Day, especially we celebrate each year. But when we assess the development and the upliftment of the black man, the African people at home and abroad, nothing really has changed, you know. So we came with this theme this year, like Africans at home and abroad, we should liberate ourselves, you know, from this hypocrisy and denial, you know what I mean? That's why I say at home and abroad, because the brethren and sisters come from their blood, but they don't get a lot of support, they don't get a lot of love, they don't feel love like they're coming back home because of hypocrisy and denial among the Africans and the African governments who are there in at home in Africa. So I've got my brother here, Las Naija, yes I, elder from Uganda. Let him talk and you'll hear what him say on Yetu.
Yes, yes, yeah. Greetings in the name of Him, Imperial Majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie I, the first Jehovah Jah,
Rastafari,
yes, ever sir. Living, ever faithful, ever sure, the yes. Conquering Lion of the tribe of Judah.
Yes, sir.
Yes, it's a must, it's a critical point, Brother Kaya Person.
Yes. Yes.
This is a universal message.
Yes.
It is true, indeed. It's wrong in celebrating African Liberation Day, because there's never been such a day.
Mm.
The African came out of slavery in the 60s.
Yeah.
And the African living in America only happened to get a few rights accepted by the Americans in America in the same time, in the 60s, 70s, and 80s.
Mm.
So indeed, the black race is still under oppression worldwide.
Yeah.
And even for the mere fact that the colonialists have not taken it to the International Criminal Court,
yeah,
as the first genocide on the first race who lived in the first land, Zion, which we now know as Africa, Africa, who created the first civilization that we now call the Egyptian civilization. The Africans, the black race, are the Egyptians. They are the people from Kemet. And Kemet is in vernacular, if I was to go further than that. But indeed, Pan-Africa Congress, Pan-Africanism was founded by Marcus Garvey.
Marcus Mosiah Garvey.
Marcus Garvey is the modern day prophet,
mm,
who prophesied to the blacks in the diaspora,
all
and
of
those
them
at home, to
Malcolm
look
X,
to the east.
Martin Luther, all of them, Elijah Muhammad, all of them. They are the products of Marcus
Garvey.
Yeah.
Him asked them to look to the east,
mm,
for the crowning of one who will be known as the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Indeed, when Marcus Garvey made this prophecy, he said if it doesn't happen in the next period of time he had given it to occur, there would be a drought in the Caribbean. And there was no rain. And after the coronation in 1930,
yeah,
it rained in the Caribbean heavily.
Mm.
Now, Pan-Africa was meant to repatriate blacks home. It was founded on a black star liner, a 7-mile long line of cruise ships that Marcus Garvey himself built to take everyone who wanted to move back to their homeland, Africa, from the West.
Yeah.
When the Europeans found out this plan of his, they could not accept it, and Marcus was.
Yes.
But Pan-Africa is supposed to seek for reparations.
Mm.
The colonialists are supposed to pay the blacks all over the world for reparations,
yeah,
for slave trade, because that's the original sin.
Mm.
The original sin is not Adam and Eve eating an apple. That could not be a sin. How could eating a fruit be a sin? This is another thing that the Babylonians have used to keep you entrapped spiritually, mentally, and physically, leading to the financial losses that we are suffering. Because they gave us seeds of division. Some of those include politics, religion, economics. Barter trade is the best way we had in before. So anyway, there is no liberation for Africa until the governments that are sitting at the present day in time in Africa can charge the colonial oppressors of the slave trade for reparations. Even if it takes 5,000 years, 10,000 years, it is a crime. Way before all these other cases that are being tried in the criminal courts.
And to take out no visa charges for any Africans who are coming from abroad, coming back home.
Right.
Why do we have to keep on ripping them off? You know, there's a lot of brothers and sisters out there who want to come here. And few who have had guts to come here, they faced a lot of problems.
Yes, sir.
You know? And they had to pay a lot of money.
Right.
You know, it's not right. That's why I say hypocrisy. We have to liberate ourselves from hypocrisy. You know,
as
we say, we those are our family, but we still rip them off. That's not good. Not good at all. Take off all of the visa charges for Africans come from abroad to Africa. They have the right to come back home. This the whole continent is their home. Look at their skin and you will tell me, where is their home?
My plea is this. We have successful brethren in the Caribbean, in America, ancestors and children, black men, women and children in America, Europe, Caribbean, Asia, all over. They are seeking to repatriate and come back home.
Yes.
In Mount Zion.
Yes.
For in this time of separation, we have realized that this is the newfound Jerusalem. It has always been Jerusalem. Not the stolen rogue nation of Palestine.
Yeah.
That you now call Israel.
Yeah.
So my plea to the governments of Africa.
Yeah.
The black governments of Africa. We are here in Uganda. Open up diplomatic missions for all the black people in the Caribbean.
Yes, sir.
You have an American embassy. The black Americans do come.
Yeah.
But where are the Jamaicans and those from Trinidad and Tobago and Bermuda and Santa?
And for your information, this week, Barbados, they have taken out the Queen of England as their head of state. Now they are going to have their own head of state. We want the same thing to Jamaica, you know. We want the same thing to the whole islands and all Africans abroad. Yeah, man.
But to further add on that point,
yeah,
the amount of investment, these skilled entrepreneurs, the Michael Jordans, the Male family, the Usain Bolts, there are so many. Some are in technology, some are in medicine, some are in all kind of skills and craft, because the black man is the original man, the human.
Judah.
We are the Hebrew.
Judah.
Because as they looked at us, they said, we are not even black, we are blue.
Yeah.
They called us Hebrew.
Yeah.
Now, if the government of Uganda opened up as number one, a Jamaican embassy, think about what you're going to add to the gross domestic product in earnings and tourism and such for the nation before you can say that we're a poor land.
Yeah.
Africa's never been poor.
Yeah, man.
Africa can fit in all the other continents with space to provide.
Yeah.
Africa supplies all the other continents with surplus. How can you say we are poor? They get the uranium from here, the gold, the diamond, the coffee, the cotton, the labor is got from Africa.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thanks a lot. You're watching Here to Africa TV. Don't miss, and thanks everyone who is in touch and every time is there to watch. Don't forget to subscribe and share and comment. Share to your friends. Yeah, man. Thank you.